Hello all, welcome to our channel. In my videos, I have drawn and animated medicine and dental concepts, thereby making it simpler and more interesting to watch. Now getting on to today's concept. Forceps extraction is removal of tooth or root with the help of forceps or elevators or both being used. Blades of instrument are forced down the periodontal membrane between tooth root and bony socket wall. This closed technique is used in most of the cases termed as intra-alveolar extraction. This method employs most efficient instrument called dental forceps, having blades and handles united by hinge joint. The outside of tips should be sharp enough to cut the periodontal fibers and also enable the feel of its way along root surface, and it can be sharpened by sandpaper disc. For the ideal extraction to be performed, the inner surface of forceps blades should perfectly fit the root surface. But due to greater root variations, we can't achieve it. Hence, the root is gripped by edges of blades establishing two-point contact. Unexpectedly, if single linear contact is made, then tooth will get crushed. Thus, aim of two-point contact leads us to utilize the proper forceps to be used. Another significant principle to be followed on the selection of forceps is the long axis of the blades should be parallel to the long axis of tooth root. After seating the patient comfortably in the dental chair with appropriate height, anesthesia should be given. The forceps should be picked up by right hand to have a proper grip and control over it. Now let's have a look over the significant role of left hand in each and every extraction. Basically, the left hand is used for displacement of soft tissue site to improve visual and mechanical access. Especially while extracting mandibular teeth, left hand supports and fixes the mandible, thereby preventing dislocation of mandible. Fingers of left hand also supports the alveolar bone of the tooth to be extracted and also transmits the status of the procedure to the operator. Finally, it is used to compress the socket and taking out the tooth or root from the mouth. After obtaining the position of left hand, the right hand grasps the forceps with thumb placed just below the joint and forceps handles are in the palm of the hand. With your long axis parallel to the tooth, applying on buccal and lingual surface of it, with a little finger placed inside the handle to control the opening of the blades. More commonly, a grip is achieved in crown instead of root, leads to crown fracture, especially if the tooth is heavily distorted. So the blades are forced through periodontal membrane between tooth root and alveolar bone with a firm pressure as far as possible. Once the grip is achieved with root, the little finger is positioned outside the handle. In the cases of less accessible side or tooth with cervical caries buccally or lingually, the blade is applied to these side first under direct vision. The safety measure ensures the blade grips the sound root, thus reducing tooth fracture. Then firm, controlled and smooth pressure is given in buccolingual direction and then in the linguobuccal direction. By doing these lateral movements for few times, the tooth get loosened and rise out of its socket. By this time, rotatory or figure of 8 movement will deliver the tooth effectively, thereby avoiding gross distortion of buccal plate as a result of excessive lateral forces. For tooth with straight conical roots, this rotatory movement itself is enough to permit their detachment from socket. Only if there is any resistance felt, then buccolateral movements is utilized to deliver the tooth. The delivered tooth is inspected to ensure that it is complete and compression of extracted socket is done with a left thumb and forefinger which supports healing. In our above said definition, elevators are also used in extraction and they work on the principle of lever and fulcrum, where alveolar crest acts as fulcrum. Elevator should be grasped in fingers and forced down the periodontal membrane at an angle of 45 degree to the long axis of the root. The tip of the index finger rests against alveolar bone, which provides good control over the instrument. Now let's see about certain significant details before applying any force on the tooth. The line of withdrawal is the path along which tooth or root will move out of its socket with minimal application of force, which determines the site on the root where force must be applied, called as point of application of an elevator. For straight and conical roots, the line of withdrawal is upwards and slightly lingually. So the elevator must be applied to its buccal surface. Where in the case of distally pointing roots, the line of withdrawal is upwards and backwards, leading to the point of application on the mesial surface. Likewise, if root points mesially, a distal application is utilized to elevate the tooth upwards and forwards out of its socket. Once the elevator is applied to the tooth, it should be rotated around its long axis so that the lower edge of its blade engages the root surface and moves the tooth out of the socket. Thanks for watching. Hope you will like my video. Please share, subscribe and comment.